Madam, when you say that it is the same as that of the Upanishads, there is again a question. The Upanishads have been interpreted by the different acharyas in a different way. So, Upanishadic concept of Atman is just a vector. Not only that, sir. The point is this, that shall we accept the Sankhya interpretation of the Upanishad or Vedantic interpretation of the Upanishad, and even in Vedanta, Vaishadvai or Vishishtadvai or Shuddhadvai, again there are questions. Therefore, it's not perhaps possible to compare Jain concept with Upanishadic concept as such. You can put the question, is it nearer Sankhya or is it nearer Sankhya Vedanta? That question can be put. But to say that is it near the Upanishad is a difficult question. Now, in Samhita, Acharya Sumpuri was describing the nature of Atman. And then he found that what I am saying appears to be nearer Sankhya. And therefore, he becomes cautious and says, please, don't confuse my statement with Sankhya. That is what he himself said. That is to say, if you ask the Vedic system, then Jain concept of Atman comes nearer to Sankhya, but it is not exactly Sankhya. That is how we have to
understand. But shall we take it in the sense, Abhyaksa, it is beyond?
Yes, because the language is limited.
Yes, comparison is there.
Thanks. It was indeed an intellectual feast for us, the whole discussion for this paper. And now I request our chairperson to felicitate us.